Hello dear students, in this video lesson I am going to discuss chapter number 1 of history and the name of the chapter is How, When and Where. History. It is the study of past events and it is much more than memorizing dates. In this lesson we shall study about how did it happen, when did it happen and where did it happen. History, that is all about the changes that occur over time. So finding about how the things they were in the past and how things they have changed or evolved, that's all about the history. So let's begin with how important are dates. There was a time when historians, they were fascinated with dates. There were heated debates about the dates on which rulers were crowned or battles were fought. In the common sense notion, history was synonyms with dates. You may have heard people saying, I find history boring because it's all about memorizing dates. Is such a conception true? History, that is certainly about the changes that occur over time, which I have already discussed with you. So as soon as we compare the past with the present, we refer to the time we talk of before and after. This is the illustration which is given on page number 1 in your textbook, in which Brahmins are offering the Shastras to Britannia. It's a front piece to the first map, which was produced by James Rennell in 1782. Watching someone sip a cup of tea at a roadside tea stall, you may wonder, when did people begin to drink tea or coffee? Similarly, looking out of the window of a train, you may ask yourself, when were railways built and how did people travel long distances before the age of railways? Likewise, reading the newspaper in the morning, you may be curious to know how people got to hear about things before newspapers began to be printed. Such historical questions, they come in our mind. Sometimes it is actually incorrect to fix precise dates to processes that happen over a period of time. People in India did not begin drinking tea on one fine day. They developed a taste for it over time. Likewise, we cannot determine a specific date when British rule that was started, as it happened over a span of time. See the advertisement given on the right. Old advertisements, they help us understand how markets for new products they were created and new taste were popularized. Consider an example. In the histories written by British historians in India, the rule of each Governor General was important. These histories, they begin with the rule of the first Governor General Warren Hastings and end it with the last Viceroy Lord Mountbatten. In the separate chapters, we read about the deeds of others like Hastings, Wellesley, Bentinck, Dalhousie, Canning, Curzon and many more. It was a seemingly never-ending succession of governor-generals and viceroys. All the dates in these history books were linked to these personalities only, to their activities, policies, achievements, many more. When we write history or a story, we divide it into chapters. Why do we do this? It is to give each chapter some coherence, meaning the link or the connectivity. So dear students, this was all about this module. We shall continue the chapter with the next module. Thank you. Have a nice day.